Hey YouTube, my name is Dan and this is a short free extract of my longer course called Animated Infographics and Data Visualization. That course, along with the free exercise files for this particular video and a free downloadable cheat sheet, can be found at bringyourownlaptop.com. Hi there, in this video we're going to look at easing. Basically, it's going to turn boring animation into something a little bit more lifelike and interesting. So the bottom one really is going to be boring, the top one is going to be nice with easing. Boring, nice, boring, nice. See? Okay, easing just adds a little bit of life to pretty much any animation in After Effects. Let's go and do that now. Okay, so to work on easing, we're going to click on our icon one house. Okay, and what we're gonna do is twirl this down so we can see the keyframes that we're working on. Now, this can be quite complicated as in we can see anchor point and position, and it's quite messy, especially when you start twirling down a few of these. Okay, it gets all kind of ugly looking. To make it a little nicer is have this layer selected, have it completely twirled up, and click the U key on your keyboard. All that does is that it brings down only the attributes that have keyframes applied to them. So the stuff you're probably gonna work with. So it's hiding anchor point and position. They're still there, you can close it up, open it back up, but just type U, keeps everything nice and clean while you're working. Okay, I'm gonna get my player close, hit the plus key to zoom in. Now at the moment, it's doing this kind of like, it's not very nice. I'm gonna turn off the sound. Okay, see these here? I turn these off just so that I can't hear the music. The problem is if you export it, okay, it'll have no music and voiceover. So make sure you turn them back on. So, yeah, very PowerPointy. Okay, just kind of like appears a bit lame. So what I want to do is apply easing. Now what a lot of people do is they'll select this keyframe, so I'm holding down shift and click both of them, they go blue. Right click any one of them, and actually you can click F9 if you're on a PC, and that applies easy ease. If you're like me on a Mac, and F9 opens up a bunch of other things, like iTunes or something, okay, you can't use that shortcut. But if you right click any of them, go to keyframe assistant, and there's easy ease, okay? That there changes them from diamonds to these little hourglasses, and it gives it a little bit of easing. Watch this, it's better. Okay, it's a little hard to see, okay, but it gives it a little bit of resistance at the beginning and the end, and gives it a little bit of light. And that's going to be a huge part of this class. We're going to look at easing plus a bunch of other tricks to give our icons a bit of anthropomorphism. Okay, so what we're going to do is, so easy ease is great. I never use it because I like to crank it up even higher. So to do that, you can manually type it in. So I'm going to right click it, and we're going to go to this one. Instead of assistant, go to keyframe velocity. So what easy ease does is it changes it from 0 to 33.3%. Okay, and that's kind of like, gives it a little bit of influence, but I like to crank it right up to 75. 75 on both of these. Okay, both the in and out points works fine. Click OK. So it's kind of like an easy ease, but like extreme version. Now, kick back and watch this. I like it lots more anyway. Okay, it's just got a better flow to it. If it's going a little fast, I feel like mine is. I'm just gonna click on one of these icons and separate them out. Yeah, that's got a nicer feeling to it. That, my friends, is considered ease. We're actually using velocity, but you can use those terms in this case interchangeably. Now we could do it to the fade in. Okay, so I'm gonna zoom out, go back, I'm gonna minus out a little bit so I can see my whole animation. Remember this text fades in. Okay, so to see just, I'm clicking on the text layer. How do I see just the keyframes that we made for this? Remember the fade in? That's right, click U on your keyboard. So there's my keyframes. Now I could do easing for this, but for opacity, you can't see the difference. You might decide that you play around with it and you're like, you can see the difference in easing in opacity, and that's totally fine. I just find like, it doesn't really matter what velocity you play around with it. There's not a whole lot of difference when you're playing with transparency or opacity. So I'm just gonna leave those and get on to the next video. Hey there, what'd you think? If you liked the video, hit the like button, that'd be great. Also consider subscribing to my channel. Now this is a free part of a longer course. You can check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. On that site is a free downloadable, printable PDF cheat sheet, okay, to help you with your infographics and data visualization. Also on that site is a bunch of other courses as well. So go check it out, bringyourownlaptop.com. Bye now.